Welcome to the second week of the Node.js Microservices for Oracle Cloud MOOC. In this lesson, I show you how to modularize your Node.js applications to organize your code to make it easier to maintain and reuse code. A Node.js module is a script that exposes some functions or properties. To use a module, you use the required function in your scripts. A module can require other modules. And you can add external modules to your application using npm. Modules included using npm are stored in the node modules folder. Inside, you find a folder for each of the modules installed with npm. Also, you can create your own modules for your application by creating node scripts and requiring them. A script is required using the relative path to the script file. Now, when you require a script file, it is executed in its own scope. This means that the required script file can't access variables outside the script, and any function or variable declared inside can't be accessed from the outside. To make functions or variables visible to the invoking script, you must add it to the module.exports object. You use the module.exports object to share your module functionality. Anything you add to the module.exports object will be exposed. Now, a thing to consider is that the required functions are cached. The exported object is only created once and it's shared. For this reason, it is usually advised to expose methods that provide functionality or in any case construct objects that you use. This is the case with the Express framework. Notice how you require the Express, but to start using it, you use a function call to create the Express application, and then you interact with this constructed object. This is true for Body Parser as well. Notice that the only instance you use it is when you call a method that returns an instance of the Body Parser object used in Express. Okay, now you know the basic of modules, so let's start modularizing the project. One thing that is immediately modularizable is the application configuration. And right now, the only configuration I have in the application is the port variable. In the future, I can store all kinds of configurable variables in the config module. So how do you start? I recommend creating folders. Folders helps you keep organized. Of course, you could have separate JavaScript files only, but I really like having separate folders, one for each type of module I'm creating. This way, I can organize my modules better. So I create a config folder in my project, and then inside I create a new config.js file. Now open that file. Okay, I want to create a really simple module. What I can do is export an object directly that has all my application configuration. This is done by assigning an object to the module.exports property. And inside this object, I can organize my configuration variables using child objects and properties. Okay, in my object, I create a property server. So here I want to allocate all my server configuration. As value, I assign another object. Now, inside this object, I create the port property and set it to process.env.port or 8888. Remember, this is the correct syntax for defining the port variable that uses the Oracle Cloud configuration or a default port to test locally. Okay, this completes the module code. Pretty simple, huh? Notice I am exposing a simple object in my module.exports. Okay. Now, for a far more complicated module. In fact, I want to create two modules, the services module and the data module. Let's go back to the drawing board. My idea here is the following. Create a service module that is going to be my HTTP service, and create a data module that is going to provide the HTTP service with my movie data. Also, I have the common operations to modify data in here, like create, update, and delete. Why am I doing this? Well, it's pretty simple. Now my data service is going to be in the in-memory collection, but later on this course, I want to use a database instead. So instead of modifying a big file, scavenging for the code that does the data access, I can create another module that exposes the same methods as the in-memory version but uses a database instead. This sounds a lot like object-oriented design, doesn't it? Well, okay. Now, I need to create a data folder and a services folder. The data module will be inside the data folder, and the HTTP or Express server will be inside the services folder. Open the server.js file. Now, here's the tricky part. Pieces of this file will go to the data module. Pieces will go to the server module. Which goes where will be discussed in the following lesson, but for now, I want to show you what I want my final design to look like. I'll add some space to separate the old code from the new. And now I want to require my modules first. The service, the config, and the data. And then I want to do a simple server start, provide the configuration and the data. And in theory, the rest will be taken care of inside the start method of my server. This might look as an oversimplistic design, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. I have to start from somewhere. Thus, if I keep it simple, I can figure out the details later. Now I got a design and a plan. In the next video, I show you how to create the service and data modules. If you want more information on how to create a node module, you can find it in the Node.js official documentation.